Jeffrey Herlings, when he went back out on track, obviously deciding not to get into a battle with them.
But the track is really starting to dry up just in the main line.
Yeah.
And because the main line is one or two, one right next to it, that line has gotten so, it's a war zone out there. It's so rough that, you know, when riders can move around the track a little bit, it doesn't get as rough in one spot.
Well, I was looking at, I think Tommy, a couple of laps ago when he came down St. Helens, and if you look, you can see the dry line as they come out of the turn and down there, in fact, where Tommy is now, out of our camera position, that left side seems to be the line that has dried out the most, and it's only, what, handlebar width apart, maybe just over.
Well, this MX2 coming up, or MX1, I should say, coming up next, those big bikes and that, the first couple of laps, that'll clear a lot of it off, but you're not going to fix that.
No.
That's just a big muddy puddle that's probably not going to, this is going to be an inside line and an outside line before the end of the day.
Well, Ken Roczen had an 8-point advantage over Jeffrey Herlings before we came here. If he brings it home in, what, about three or four corners time, he's going to extend that to 11 points. His championship lead is going to be extended again after Herlings took 6 points back off of him at the last round in Holland 3 weeks ago. But still, we've got one race to go here for the Grand Prix of the US, the US GP. As Ken Roczen comes out of the final corner, backmarker just crosses his path there, and Roczen takes 25 points in the checkered flag, and he looked just giving the gesture there to the backmarker as he almost got took out going through that final turn. Backmarker just moved clean across the front of him to the opposite side of the track.